welcome back to the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino here in Hollywood, Florida, as we get set for our next bout, scheduled 10 rounds in your light heavyweight division. Before we introduce our combatants first, let me introduce to you the man in charge of the action in the squared circle when the bell rings. Ladies and gentlemen, your referee in charge, Armando Garcia. All right, fight fans, here we go. 10 rounds in your light heavyweight division. Introducing your combatants as such. Introducing first, in the corner to my right, from Cartagena, Colombia. He tipped the scales at 169.5 fighting pounds. He has a very impressive record at 23 victories with only 3 defeats. 21 of those victories coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, wearing camouflage and tonight, fighting from the blue corner, I give to you the IBO Intercontinental Champion, Alejandro Berrio. His opponent stands opposite in the corner to my left. From Kitchener, Ontario, Canada, this man weighed in at 171 fighting pounds. He takes a very impressive record also of 35-3 into the ring this evening. 23 big wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight he fights from the red corner wearing the black trunks trimmed in red. I give to you Sid the Jewel Vanderpool. Once again, here is your referee Armando Garcia with last minute instructions. 10 rounds in your light heavyweight division.
I'm gonna be English with you and Spanish with him, so pay attention. Español contigo, inglés con él, así que pega atención, okay? Good, clean fight. Obey my commands and protect yourself at all times. Don't make me pull you guys apart, okay? Una pelea limpia, obedece y protégete en todo momento. No me hagas estar hablándote, okay? Te separa cuando yo te digo, okay? Good luck. Buena suerte. Touch gloves. Toca guante.
So, Vanderpool and Berrio ready to go. Vanderpool 32, 4 years older than Berrio. Berrio with a significant height advantage. The reach pretty similar, and the weight 171, 169. So that is the tail of the tape. We start the action. Here we go. Set for 10. Very, very interesting battle. Sid Vanderpool, the lefty, and Berrio, his opponent from Cartagena, Colombia. Berrio, known as a good body puncher.
Right off the bat, Berrio is fighting a southpaw against Sid, and he sees he knows how to fight a southpaw. He's keeping his left foot on the outside. As soon as Sid came out in the southpaw position, it's Berrio to his left, which is the proper way to go fight the southpaw.
So for Berrio, that right hand lead would be there. Double left hook would be there. And as you mentioned, keeping your lead foot outside, out of your opponent.
Seeing Sid fight before, Sid is very strong. Very, very strong.
It's interesting, we talked to him about the loss to Jeff Lacy. And he's been doing well boxing. But he decided to slug in the middle of that fight, and it proved disastrous to him.
Yeah, but he said he learned from it. He learned. Once he learned, being a fighter, once you learn from something, you go back and you analyze. You're your worst critic. And I'm sure he's going to come out there and be effective this fight.
And Tracy Patterson, his new trainer, saying he's worked with Sid about the angles, the movement, trying to make him slick and slippery, as well as a jewel. And there are some good people around him. Stan Hoffman, who has been the manager of 36 world champions, has come on board as well. So Sid Vanderpool is loading up for a run. And that was a pretty good double combination to get all at once, Tracy Patterson and Stan Hoffman.
Yeah, I would say so. Very nice.
Stan Hoffman's been around the likes of Joe Louis Manley, Iran Barkley, most recently Hasim Rahman,
Sid's going, he's being very effective to Barrios' body with that left uppercut being the southpaw himself. I see the punch that he's throwing with that left uppercut. He's being effective with it.
So the opening round has been an active one with Berrio stalking Vanderpool. We saw Vanderpool a year ago dismantle a very promising Tito Mendoza, beaten decisively by moving and taking away Mendoza's right hand. So we come to the end of the opening round. Berrio stalking and Vanderpool on the move.
Once again, fight fans in attendance, and your time limit is ticking away. The exercise will be dropped for those two front row seats to the upcoming card. If you haven't already done so, please drop it in your pocket and check
it for the winner. In front of them, you don't pull up. Put your head right in his chest, leave it there. All right, I'll step around one way or the other. But don't pull straight up in front of him, all right? Watch that right in. Keep doing what you're doing. Tear that body up. We're going to break that body up, all right?
Each guy brought a little something to the table here.
We got some heat. We got some heat going into this round. These guys are putting these punches together very well. Stand on the outside, Sid being more effective by putting combinations together.
So here we go into round two. Sid Vanderpool against Alejandro Berrio. Vanderpool coming in at 35-3, 23 knockouts. Berrio is 23-3, 21 knockouts, which means his opponents do not last distance. He doesn't usually win a decision. He doesn't have to.
Look at
Berrio stalking on Vanderpool.
Looking at both of these guys, you would look at Sid and see such a physique that he has on him. Look at Berrios, real skinny, you know, not a thick guy. Sure, those punches do hurt.
Sure. And here he comes now as a southpaw. Berrio going back into a left-handed move here, putting the body on Vanderpool, and Vanderpool back up on top of him. So we've got some point-counterpoint. As this fight is starting to settle into a nice, heated rhythm. Good work.
Good right hook
by Vanderpool. He shook up Berrio. Berrio backing up. Here comes Vanderpool's chance. Vanderpool opening up. Berrio is hurt. Vanderpool going for everything here. Berrio did not cover up. He did not grab. He did not hold. He just took Vanderpool's best.
Sid's throwing some very effective punches, very strong punches. Berrios is taking them. Haven't been a clean shot yet, but still taking them. Good body shot by Sid.
Vanderpool working the body in a good straight left hand by Vanderpool, snaking its way through. Now Vanderpool again. Berrio trying to tie him up this time. These body shots, they don't do major damage now. They will certainly have an effect later on in this bout.
It looks to me that Berrios has a great chin. If I was Sid, I would tell Tracy to go down to the body. If he goes down to the body, the head will come.
There's no such thing as a wasted body shot.
No, not at all, because the later round, it's going to take effect.
So Vanderpool fires a right hook. He's been warned twice now for low blows in this round. Ball leaping left hand by Vanderpool. Do too much, referee can take a point away from him. So Sid Vanderpool has broken open the stalemate. An excellent second round for Vanderpool. Berrio gets another round to work with. That's the best thing for him.
¿Qué pasa? ¿Cómo te sientes? estamos bien, no pasa nada.
Agua.
No pasa nada, vamos, vamos, bien.
No me agua, no me agua.
Cuídame, vaselina, vaselina. Ahí la sé, aquí, hielo, aquí está. Aquí, hielo una cosita tu vida. Tiene que subirme la guardia. Trágame los golpes por dentro. Te está regando, te está con la guardia abajo. No puede bajarme la guardia.
We go to the action here in the second round. That good right hook by Sid that was landed flush. He's coming in, put punches together. He's landed. As you can see, his head is wide open, and Sid's cracked him with a left hook, but didn't affect him. Sid's on the prowl now, coming in with a straight left hand, go back to the body and come back to the head. Sid's doing a great job at picking this guy apart. Here we go again. You have Sid come at that straight left hand. He's been open shot for Sid throughout round two.
So Sid the Jewel Vanderpool, very cool in round two, doing the work here on Alejandro Berrio. Scheduled for 10 in the light heavyweight division. Vanderpool 35-3, 23 knockouts. Berrio 23-3, 21 knockouts. Now Berrio trying to rally after he was stunned in the last round. And this fight has all kinds of back and forth potential. I mean, Berrio has an intercontinental belt, so he's used to being a very good fighter and being on the fringes of contention. And Sid Vanderpool fought for a world title.
I don't think Berrio's belt is on the line tonight. We have an excellent fight here, we do have to say. He's got a lot of power. A lot of power with these guys.
This is the fight that when we looked at it, we said this is the one that could steal the show. It just had a certain sense about it. Now the question is, will it go long enough to do that? Because these guys have taken turns opening up with some big bombs.
As you mentioned earlier, Dave, that Sid is more effective with his punches, being on the inside, and coming in on the outside also being effective with his punches.
Yeah, multifaceted attack by Vanderpool. And the outside work is a product of quickness. Look at the quick feet that Vanderpool has getting out of range. The Berrio is very live.
I see when he fought Tito Mendoza, he confused him, just like he's trying to do, because he's moving him. He's trying to confuse Berrio. Berrio is just punching together, trying to catch him. He's trying to catch up to him. We'll see if he can take him on out of it.
We had seen Tito Mendoza in a lot of fights, and nobody was ever able to make him look the way Vanderpool did.
Punch out,
he made Tito lunge, get very frustrated, hit after the bell. He totally took him out of his game. And that's one of Vanderpool's key points.
Certainly did. It's a great uppercut by Berrios.
Body shot here by Vanderpool. Right hand by Berrio. Berrio driving. Vanderpool back, trying to land the right-hand lead. And Vanderpool right back with some quickness.
Berrio's coming in. Berrio's coming in. He's throwing great body shots, but his head is still stuck up in there. And Sid's landing some good shots on him. He put something together to be more effective.
Berrio back. So we come to the end of round three. A nice pace to the scheduled 10 rounder. Crowd agrees. Get some nice applause.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the City of Orleans to the house. That is number 6,
Rich.
Picking up action here on the third round. We see Berrios coming in with a straight right hand. Have Sid chopped on the ropes, but Sid come back with that good left hook as Berrios came back with a straight left hand. We see Sid on the outside being more effective. He's coming in trying to set him up with a combination. We see Berrios
right hand by Vanderpool again.
Yeah, Berrios hitting with that good Berrio. Right up. Sid looks very calm and relaxed.
Into round four we go, scheduled for 10. Sid Vanderpool and Alejandro Berrio. in the light heavyweight division. We're at the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino in Hollywood, Florida. I'm Dave Fontemple along with Michael Moore.
Stop punching!
To win the heavyweight championship.
Thank you, Dave.
It's always a special thing when you see all the southpaws. I like fighting southpaws, and I like training southpaws, which I'm a trainer also now, where I can help these guys, the southpaws, if I am one. You know, being the first heavyweight champion, so that's a good resume to have.
It certainly is. Why do so many people hate to fight southpaws?
I think because they're trained. Psychologically, people say you don't want to fight a southpaw. But if you're a complete fighter, being a professional that you are, being a fighter, you should be able to face anything and adjust anything that's put in front of you.
And here's Vanderpool as the southpaw, and Berrio trying to deal with him. Berrio has an intercontinental belt. He's a quality fighter, 23-3. Sid Vanderpool emerging in the eyes of people in South Florida last April with a stunningly easy, at least that he made it look that way, victory over Tito Mendoza, and then he showed flashes of the same against Jeff Lacy before that fight went south on him. But that was for a heavyweight, that was for a world championship. Vanderpool, a cool customer here with Tracy Patterson, former featherweight champion, in his corner. And Berrio, right there, willing. He would be ready to pounce on any mistake.
Berrio looked confused. He looked at his corner briefly because he looks confused because he can't capitalize on his mistakes. And he looks like he's just confused right now. That's what Sid has a reputation of doing, confusing his fighters.
Just some beautiful movements here by Vanderpool going in and out. You get going one way, you think he's going to throw a jab, and then he throws a power punch. You think he's going to get on the inside, and he moves. And Armando Garcia will warn them both about headbutting. We don't want to see this one short-circuiting.
I believe Berrio is very confused right now. He's getting antsy right now, where he wants to land the more effective blows.
Well, you know, I think the patience of Vanderpool is starting to wear him out.
Exactly right. I couldn't have said it no better, baby.
Vanderpool is a composite picture of composure as we come to the end of the round.
Oye, ¿qué es lo que pasa? Vamos a levantar la pelea. Estamos abajo en la pelea. Hay que levantar. Vamos, toma el agua. Súbeme la guardia. Súbeme la guardia que estaba fuerte. ¿Cómo te sientes? Entonces yo confío en ti. Piensa en tu familia. Dame la golpe por dentro. Vamos a ponerle la
conexión. Vamos. Aire. Aire. Vamos arriba.
Respira. Respira.
Respira. Más arriba. Vamos arriba.
Picking up some action from the last round, we see that Berrio came in with that straight right hand and hit Sid. And we have action here again as Sid coming down to the body. Coming across with the overhand left, being a softball. As the round ended, you see the two bumped into each other and Sid kept a cool head and just walked back into his corner, and Berrio came out and tried to go after him, but his corner came in and stopped him.
As we start round five, there are no rules covering accidental shoulder bumps. So these guys took it into their own hands. Are you looking at me, man? Into round five we go. Here's Alejandro Berrio. Going forward here, and Vanderpool striking back, and Berrio opening up back. It gets exciting, a right hand by Berrio. Vanderpool along the ropes, but perhaps voluntarily. Good shots here by Berrio. Leaping right hand comes up short, but the uppercut did not. The left uppercut scores. The crowd getting up. Berrio has a number of fans in here.
You see Sid still staying cool, calm, and collected. But Berrio's putting that heat on him.
Berrio getting an adrenaline rush. We talked last round about how he was impatient. And here in round five, he's even a little bit more animated as he jumps in on Vanderpool after the referees had broken it. Really is coming on for Berrios. He is sensing that this could be a big momentum chance for him. A right hand by Berrios. Another body shot by Berrios.
Berrios seems very, very confident right now. Sid, he may be breaking Sid down now because he has someone that can punch with him.
It is something, Michael, how from one round to the next, something could just light a fire under a fighter. And it might have been what happened at the end of the round.
I see that Sid has a little mouse over his left eye, and his nose is blood from the left nostril.
Vanderpool landing the straight left hand, Berrios back at him. Just pawing with the jab. Fires the left hook, and Vanderpool tries to tie him up. And now some blood coming out of the nose of Vanderpool.
Sid looks to be a little tired, a little winded in this round. He's not stable on his feet. Maybe Berrios can capitalize on it. He's still a game fighter.
Body shot to the right hook by Vanderpool. Right hand by Berrios. Good right hand by Berrios. A tremendous round.
Sid looks like he's putting everything into the punches. And he's trying to land.
I'll tell you what would be the biggest crime of all. Would be to lose this round 10-9. The fans really love it what happened here in round five.
Berrios is putting that pressure on Sid. He's coming in, they're being effective with that good left uppercut by Berrios. Maybe confusing Sid a little bit because Sid looks at the guy's body. Maybe he's not timid of it. But we see that Sid's trying to wrap up, but Berrios keep punching. And he's initiating the fight by being dictating by throwing that straight right hand and catching him with it. Stepped on that left foot of his.
So in the round six we go. Scheduled for 10. Alejandro Berrios in the black trunks. 23-3. 21 knockouts. He's in the green trunks. Sid Vanderpool in the black. 35-3. 23 knockouts. We're at the Seminole Hard Rock.
You're exactly right.
Hotel and Casino in Hollywood, Florida. And Night does Hard Knocks at the Hard Rock. We're getting that. Up here, Berrios and Vanderpool. Vanderpool started out quickly, but in round five, Berrios jumped into another level.
Being an intercontinental champion, I see that Berrios, he knows how to turn the fire on and he has to turn it on.
Berrios won some fans in round five that started to lose them by gesturing at Vanderpool. Fans did not like that. And there's a straight left hand by Vanderpool as Berrios just walked in and didn't jam his way in like he was doing last round.
Looks to me as Sid is getting restless, he's getting tired. I think he underestimated Berrios, probably like a lot of other people did. But Berrios coming in, Intercontinental WBO champion, maybe he's going to be effective. You never know.
Well, some people did underestimate Berrios. But you wonder if Vanderpool can even afford to do that. Coming off a loss, he needs to build the big wins. That's a luxury he can't afford.
He's trying to get away now because Berrios put that heat on him.
Good body shot by Berrios. Good right hand by Berrios.
Stop.
Vanderpool tying him up. Mendoza, he had points in the bank and he could do this.
would say that Sid needs a knockout against this guy if he wants to be victorious.
Oh, you're holding. Let's go. Punch out. Stop punching.
Some great punches together.
You're holding. Okay, come on.
Who knows? As you can see, he has a granite chin because Sid is hitting with some hellacious shots. And he's still there, still coming.
So you think Vanderpool is already in that point in round six that he needs a knockout?
He's desperate right now. He's desperate. Look at him. Look at his face. He's desperate.
He did well in the first couple of rounds, but Berrio has taken the play away. So round six works its way out. There's a mouthpiece coming out. And some respect comes to the fighters.
Hay que subir la pelea. Ahí está, voy a no hay juego de Vanderpool. No hay juego de Vanderpool. Hay que llavear. Está caminando sin llavear. ¿Qué vas?
Pásame mano.
Hay que llavear.
Está cansado.
Está más cansado que tú.
Here we take a look at the pass action from the last round. We see Berrio still the aggressor. He's making Sid have to fight his fight by putting punches together and making Sid come to him. Berrio still working that body, working that head. He's keeping his head up, though. That's the only thing I would say. Sid's coming in, being effective. As we see here, we got that jab, left hook, right hook. That was a good straight left hand. Berrio hit. We have Sid knock his mouthpiece out. Out of mutual respect for each other, the two just left the referee breaking up.
All right, so we go into round seven. Sid Vanderpool, Alejandro Berrio, locked up. The fight we thought they would be in. Excellent battle in the light heavyweight division. Berrio has come on like gangbusters in round five and six after Vanderpool had things going the way he wanted. But there's a big left hand by Berrio, and he continues to apply the pressure. Good right hand by Berrio. Vanderpool backing up. Big shot.
Looking over to his corner, Berrios is very confident right now because you know he can hurt the guy. Berrios coming to be more effective, put punches together. Sid just laying back.
Here comes Berrio, big right hand. Uppercut by Berrio. Vanderpool is in gut check time. He has to get through this. Big right hand by Berrio. He's taking target practice. Vanderpool in deep trouble. You have to fight back or the ref will stop it.
I think Sid's looking for a one-punch knockout, but he has to put those punches together to be more effective with it.
Berrio with a knockdown to his credit. A big right hand by Berrio. Vanderpool looks like he's too tired to withstand what Berrio is throwing at him.
I see it. You see Berrio leaned over the rope and just blew a kiss to somebody on the outside. He's very confident right now.
He sees a fighter who's tired, who is laboring. Vanderpool tries for one shot back.
I don't think Sid's going to knock him out like that. I think he has to put the punches together instead of one punch. He can't knock him out. This guy has a granite chin. And he can take his best shots.
Berrio with a right hand. Good body shot by Berrio. And Vanderpool with a left hand lets him know that he is still there. Vanderpool backing up and Berrio making it obvious that Vanderpool is running by putting his hand on his hip.
Berrio took by Berrio. Berrio wants to fight. Sid doesn't want to fight. Sid seems like Sid wants to survive right now because he's taking a hit and he's been hurt by him. Took one knee. He's bloody. His face is battered. Both eyes are has mouses in it.
Since the beginning of round five, Berrio has fought like an angry man. He's been in charge.
Hey!
Get up, get up, get up.
Grip them by the side. Say, come back with the hooks, all right? Tighten them up, though. You're a little too wide. You're too wide.
Can we go back to the seventh round? We see Mario Pena hit with a straight left hook. Julio Cid, a great uppercut that twisted around, and he was hurt. He just went down and took one knee, which is a smart veteran fighter. If you're hurt, take a knee. Don't try to be a man and try to get out there and think you're not hurt. See Barrios, and you see him blew a kiss over. And you see him blew a kiss over the road.
So as we get ready for round eight, and Barrio put the coup de grace on here against Cid Vanderpool. Alejandro Barrio, the IBO Intercontinental Champion. Been gangbusters against Cid Vanderpool, who is tiring rapidly.
Great uppercut.
No, hold on.
As Vanderpool has seen this fight rapidly slip away in rounds 5, 6, and 7. And yet it's one thing to say, he needs a knockout.
Stop punching,
but when you're tired like that, that's the last thing you think you can do.
Absolutely. Because he's out on his feet. And you see his feet. He's out. Cid is out on his feet. Barrio's very fresh. If you look at him, he's fresh. He's switching up, left, righting. He's doing everything he has to do. Looks like we butted heads there.
Barrio has shown a multitude of skills. Good left hook by Barrio.
Barrio's been very, very effective with that left uppercut. And he's caught him twice with it. And I think that's going to be his home run punch by hitting with that left uppercut or right uppercut, coming out with the left hook or right hook, whatever stance he's in.
Barrio looks quite comfortable fighting the lefty. He's thrown the right hand lead, he's thrown the uppercut, and he's got Vanderpool moving into constant sources of danger.
He's holding. That's a sign of danger because he's out of it.
Come on, let's go,
Cid. He's not effective with his punches now. Going on in later rounds.
And for Cid Vanderpool, who took on Tracy Harris Patterson, who got Stan Hoffman in his corner, he's got to have one more big run, and there it could be a big left hand. Vanderpool with a bomb. Here's his chance. Right in front of him, a big left hand by Vanderpool. What a sight! These guys have both been on the verge of extinction and come back.
I don't know if that was I think he was playing possum in that fight. I mean, in that round where he thought he was hurt to try to lure Vanderpool in, but I don't think he was hurt.
Regardless, for Vanderpool, the guy is going to play possum with you. You got to him a little bit. You should jump on him and take your chance. You see the fight slipping away anyway. Why do this?
You're exactly right.
Ma 10. Che passa?
Chavez.
Respirami profondo. Respirami profondo. Respírame profundo, duro, duro, duro. Ahí, ahora respírame profundo, vamos. Vamos, último salto, hay que trabajar ahora para ganar. Este 9 hay que trabajarlo para trabajar 10 mejor. ¿Cómo te sientes? Dime, mírame los ojos. ¿Cómo te sientes? Ahí, ¿cómo te sientes? Dime, ¿cómo te sientes? Ahí, vamos. Vamos, ya lo hay. Vamos.
Ahí.
We're here to see Barrio hit him with that uppercut. That uppercut is being very effective with Barrio against Cid. Cid comes right with that straight left hand. Playing possum here. Cid should have jumped right. Cid, the reason why Cid didn't jump on him because he knew he was playing possum.
Don't need to do that as we start round 9. Cid Vanderpool. Alejandro Barrio. 10-round bout. For Cid Vanderpool of Kitchener, Ontario. shots early in the fight. Even managed to land a good one at the end of last round. But Berrio, from round five on, has stepped it up a couple different levels. And he was able to leave Vanderpool in the dust.
We got a change of action in this round. We see that early in the bout, Sid was the aggressor. He was moving a lot, but now he was tied up. Berrios is the initiator. He's more effective now than he was earlier. He's a great starter. He's a seasoned pro right
now. Berrios, from round five on, looked like a guy of top-level caliber. And it showed in his intensity, not just the mechanics, but the fire in his eyes and the fact that he would jump on opportunity.
Look at Berrios. Hungry. Sid looks like he just, he's hurt.
Second time, but that time it's not a knockdown. Berrio can't believe it because he was hitting Vanderpool at the time that Vanderpool went down.
If you look at Sid, Sid's legs are out. His legs are gone. If Berrio puts some punches together, he'll take him out. Great uppercut.
Sid. It's over. A knockout. Alejandro Berrio. And his people said yesterday, a lot of people are not thinking much about us. We're going to come in and crunch him here.
They have
talked about him being a big left hook artist to the body. He did everything else, too.
Berrio had to be very ecstatic right now because it's a great win for him. Great win for him. He's fighting a guy that used to be the champ for two more titles. He has to be very jubilant right now. Great fight. Great character. Great showmanship that he had during the fight. He never got broken down. He never, Vanderpool never broke Berrio down. Never broken down. When the fight went on, Vanderpool got broken down. Berrio had broken him down.
As you look at what he did to Mendoza, he could not do the same thing against Berrio. He came in and it was a different ballgame. Take a look at how he finishes it off. A good left hand, the right hand over the excellent left uppercut. And that was his punch tonight.
That was his most divine punch tonight. And that left uppercut, like I said earlier, the left uppercut was going to be effective on him because he hurt him the first time. He went down, I believe, the fifth round. He went down, and after he went down, that was it. He knew he had his number. And that left uppercut.
And we're glad to see that Sid Vanderpool is getting up. Alejandro Berrio with a huge victory and one that should open up a lot of eyes.
This fight here
in this division.
I see this fight here is going to derail Sid Vanderpool from any future fights as far as the title fight. I'm sure Sid stands such a great man. Sid, such a very low key, very shy person, very nice guy. You know, I'm sure he's hurt right now. You know, I'm sure he's gonna, later on, we'll get together and talk about it. But this guy, Berrio,
continues his assault. He doesn't want to win a decision. He brings his judges.
Exactly did. He both of his hands. You would look at him and think he would be nothing. I learned that a long time ago. Never judge a book by its cover.
But, man, with
skinny arms, man, they ain't hit like mules, you know?
Ladies and gentlemen, this one comes to a close at the 2 minute, 13 second mark of round number 9. Your winner by way of knockout, Alejandro Berrio.
champ.
Thank you, United States. Thank you,
LBO. Titling. Getting a lot of recognition in the boxing world with this.
As we see, Sid was coming in as Barrios hit him with that straight overhand right. And that was his punch tonight, the overhand right and the left uppercut. As you see, the left uppercut was right on the button. Sid was out here. The left uppercut just took his legs right away from him. As we see here again, the left uppercut hurt him there. Now we'll come back and do it again. That was his punch tonight. He saw after he knocked him down the first time, he came back and did it again. And that was his punch tonight.